In this tutorial, I'm gonna let you know like how you can access Jupyter Notebook from your server. So let's get started. So suppose this is your command prompt, or you can say like the server in which you are currently. This is my server. I'm using actually Raspberry Pi. You can be in AWS or whatever. So if you like, you first have to know the IP address. If you already know the IP address, then that is well and okay. And if you don't know, you just type ifconfig on the server command prompt. So yeah, so you can see this is the IP. So I have to say inet. You can see this is the IP. I have just copied the IP. If you already know, so that's well and good. So let me just take notes, copy it. Yeah. Yeah. Let me just paste it here. Okay, this is the IP of the server. So let me just clear it. So first install pip 3 install Jupyter Notebook dash dash. You get because if you have installed, then it's okay. If you haven't, so like install like this. So I have already installed, so it will say requirement satisfied. So now for making it public, your like Jupyter Notebooks, just run like Jupyter Notebook dash dash IP space 0.0.0.0. So after that, like that dash IP, then you say 0.0.0. So basically you are telling, okay, it will be accessible from everywhere. We are telling, so you are telling to let it be accessible from everywhere. So just run it. Okay, it's running. Okay, see, it's running now. So this is the like IP address. Like I'll tell you like how to access from the browser. And one more thing, let me just end it. So sometimes it doesn't run like from this command, then you have to type this command like python 3 m dash m like flag m notebook. If above command doesn't run, then you have to run this command, but 99% above command will run. So python 3 minus m notebook dash dash ip 0.0.0. so see, this is also running, this is also, both are the same thing. Okay, so if above one doesn't work, you just run this command. So now this is the IP address I have told you. So just copy the IP address and just paste it here. And on this, you can see it's running on the port 8888. It may be different on your device, but default port is 4 times 8. So just put like this and do 8888. So let me just show you in the bigger what's the IP I'm putting. So I'm putting this. It's not getting bigger. Okay, yeah, so this is the, I mean, this is the IP address. Then two, like whatever you call, I just forget name. Then 4 times 8. Yeah, so let's just enter it. So it's asking for password or token. Now go back to your like kernel or whatever. See, you can see this is the token after equal to. It might be token equal to. Just copy that token and click the right click. Okay, now token has been copied. Just come here and paste it and login. And see, it's running and it's perfectly running. You just have to give token at only one time. After that, you can just do like 100 times. It won't ask. So now you can just make like new Python 3 notebook and start working on it. So yeah, that's what all, but it works slow on the server as compared to on your own machine. So it was all from my side. Thank you.